Hi friends, my name is Radhan. So in the previous video, we'll discuss about the characteristics of collection framework, right? How many videos are done? Total 4 videos are done. This one, we'll discuss the video class number 5. Video class number 5. We'll start the practicals regarding array list. This is list implementation classes. Which one here? Array list. So previously I said, right, array list is introduced in 1.2 version. Heterogeneous data allowed, null insertion is allowed, duplicates allowed, insertion not is preserved, non-synchronized, resizable array, underlying data structure, and different cursors are there. Okay, if you want this information, check the previous video once. The characteristics are very, very important. Check the previous video. Collection video, class number 4. So now video class number 5. We will start the practicals regarding array list. I said list versus set, main difference is what? List allows duplicates, set duplicates are not allowed. It means array list allows duplicates, right? That's all. So now we'll do the practicals here. Entire collection practicals we'll do by using Eclipse ID. We'll do by using what? Eclipse ID, right? That's all. So first of all, download Eclipse ID, as you know. So Eclipse ID has two parts here. One is a JDS Eclipse ID, nothing but Java Eclipse ID, and JW Eclipse ID. Sir, no, Eclipse ID, right? Eclipse. See, project level, obviously, we're using Eclipse ID. Don't go with the Notepad. Too bad. If you're doing the practicals by using Notepad, too bad. Notepad++ also a bit bad only. Now we are using what? Edit Plus, right? Edit Plus. See, in my videos, some of the practicals I'm doing by using Eclipse ID. Some of the practicals I'm using Edit Plus. But coming to the collections, first example onwards, you will do the practicals by using ID only. By using ID only, right? Eclipse ID, that's it. What is ID full form? Integrated Development Environment. We have the IDs two ways, JTS Eclipse ID and JW Eclipse ID. As a core Java, JTS Eclipse ID is sufficient, no issues. Okay, otherwise JW Eclipse ID, right? That's all. We're clear, huh? Good. So first of all, you'll check the versions of Eclipse ID. Versions are alphabetical order here, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, right? These are the alphabetical order. H means what? Initial name, Helios, right? Helios. I means what the data here? Indigo, right? I means Indigo. J means which data here? Juno. K means what? Kepler, right? K means Kepler. L means what? Luna. M means Mars, right? Good. Well, in front of the video, don't sit ideal. Just take the pen and paper, note on all the points. M means Mars. N means what? Neon, right? Neon. O means oxygen. O means what? Oxygen, right? Oxygen, yeah, that's it. P means what? Photon. So now present version of Eclipse ID is a photon here. Yeah? Recent, last month is released. Okay, but anyhow, we are doing the practicals here by using oxygen version. By using which version here? Yeah? Oxygen, right? That's all. Let me open Eclipse ID here. This is my Eclipse here. Just open Eclipse ID. Then initially it is asking workspace here. Where you have to save your application. Give me the workspace. What is the workspace I will give here? I think the workspace is called collections applications. Okay, collections applications, right? That's all. In local disk F, collections application folder is created here. Just click on OK. Just go to the check the workspace once, local disk F, collections, applications. I think previously already one workspace is there. Now which one we are giving here? Now what is the workspace? Let me check once. First it is open here. Yeah, I think collections space applications, right? Good. Let me delete the previous workspace here, better. Collection space applications. This workspace you have to delete then. Yeah. Collections applications, right? This is workspace. Yeah. So, no, initially there is no project, right? Good. We have to create the project. Initially it is asking workspace here. Yeah? Give the some workspace location. So in local disk F, collections applications is workspace. In the workspace, the applications will be saved. Okay, the applications will be saved, right? That's all. Just minimize. Initially you will get the data like this welcome file, you will get. So just to close the welcome file. Once if you close welcome file, the Eclipse ID have the four borders, four parts are there. This is called part one. What the part one here? Project Explorer, right? Wait, part one is what? Project Explorer. All the projects are visible here. This is called work area, second part. This is called which one here? Work area, right? That's it. This is called outline here. What are the class? What are the methods? Everything is showing outline here. This is called consoles and properties, files and servers. The server starting options, ending option, property files, properties data. Okay, consoles, everything is shown here, right? That's all. Total Eclipse ID is how many parts are total? 4 parts. Project Explorer, work area, outline, consoles. First, let me create the project here. Before creating the project, in the above, you can check it here. This is Java Eclipse ID, JW Eclipse ID here. This is called JW Eclipse ID. This is called which one here? JW Eclipse ID, right? Yes or no? Good. But tell me here, core Java means JW or Java? Java, right? So in my system, I downloaded JW Eclipse ID here because I have to take the advanced Java classes, right? JW Eclipse ID generally. But you want JW Eclipse ID or Java Eclipse ID? Java Eclipse ID. So if you want Java, right hand side you have the plus operator, open prospective. Just click on open prospective. So which one you want here? Java prospective, right? By default JW is there, but I want Java. Just click on OK. Then prospect is changed, right? Java Eclipse ID. So no, your prospect is changed or not? That's all. Once the prospect is changed, let me create the project. How to create the project? File menu, new, new file menu, new. I want which one? Project, right? Java project. What the project name here? This is my collection. Tell me, this is my list data, right? ArrayList example. Simply can give the project is called what? ArrayList examples. ArrayList example, just click on what? Finish button. That's it. Now ArrayList example, some project is created, right? Project is created or not? Under the project, we have the SRC folder and JRE library, right? That's it. Go to the SRC folder here. Under the SRC, just right click here. Under the SRC, we have to right click. We have to create the class under the SRC folder, right? Source folder. Just right click here, new. Right click new, you want class, right? You want class or interface, enums, annotation. Which one you want? Select that one. Simply, I want class now. So everything, the project starts with the package. Give me some package name. Package nothing but folders, right? The folders will be generated. Com.dss folder. For the class name here, I take the test one class. Okay, I want main method, just to click on main method also here. Click on main method, right? That's all. Simply click on what here? Finish, right? That's all. But initially, the font size is, it seems very low, right? It's too low actually, font size. Can please increase the font size here. How to increase the font size? Windows, preferences, preferences. Directly here you can type the font. Directly you can type the font here. You'll get the general appearance, colors and fonts. What do you want here? Colors and fonts, right? Check the colors and fonts. Here we have the basic font. The basic, we have the text font here. In the basic, we have the text font. Text font, just you have to click on edit. You have to edit the text font, right? Bold italic, let me make it 14, right? That's okay. Click on okay, click on okay. Then tell me how to increase the font size. Go to the Windows, preferences. Here directly you can type the font, colors and font. So we have the basic first of all. In the basic, we have the text font. Click on edit, click on OK, right? That's all. Just you can check here, this is called Project Explorer, right? ArrayList, examples, SRC folder, package. Under the package, test.java. This is called work area, right? Check this outline once. I have the package name, test1, contains main method written type is void, showing outline, right? That's all. Any outline is not required, just you can close the outline and task list, leave it no issues. Here I have to write the code, right? That's all guys. Simply here, if you want to maximize the screen, just double click here, maximize. Once again, double click here, minimize. Yes or no, just double click here, maximize. Here I want to create the array list first example, right? So go to the array list. Simply can write the array list. So array list space, array list AL equal to what? New array list, new control space, new array list, right? That's all, array list is ready. See, when you import the array list, automatically package is imported. In Eclipse ID, data is automatically imported, right? That's all. I want to add the data, array list dot add of 10 value. Okay, array list dot add of 10.5, Next one is what? I'm adding int value, double value, relish.add of. I want to add the Ratan, right? Ratan is which data? String data. Next one is a relish.add of. Relish.what? Add of. I want to add the character data. Yeah, that's all. Relish.add of. Not add earlier, just add method we have to use. That's it. Add of 10. 10 I already inserted, right? Once again, I'm inserting 10 here. It means duplicates allowed or not allowed? Allowed, right? So no, duplicates allowed or not allowed? Allowed, right? That's all. So if you want null insertion, you can insert null values also, right? Al dot add, right? Add of what? Null insertion. Null insertion is also possible or not possible? Possible, right? That's it. Clear? I want print the data. To print the data, sysout control space. Sysout control space means system.out.println, right? Then al. As you know, in entire Java, whenever you are printing the array list, it internally calls which method? Internally automatically calls which method? ToString method, right? al.toString. These both lines are same, right? We are printing reference variable means it is automatically calls which method? ToString method, right? That's it. We are internally calling which method here? ToString method or not? That's all. Now tell me, array list contains one object or multiple objects here? Different types of objects, right? It means array list allows heterogeneous data. Array list allows heterogeneous data. Array list allows null values. Array list allows duplicate objects, right? That's it. Simply you can run this code, you'll get the output. How to run this code here? Here run button is there directly. Run, right? So in which order we inserted, the same order will get the output, right? 10, 10.5, Ratan, A, null, 10, right? It means insertion order is preserved or not preserved? Preserved, right? That's it. We clear, run button is there. Otherwise, we can run in one more way. Just right click here, run as Java application. Three different ways to run this code here. Just run button is there. Otherwise, in the file itself, just right click here. Run as Java application. You will get the same output. Otherwise, just minimize here. Go to the project. Under the project also right click here. Run as Java application. You will get the output here. Total how many ways here? Three ways, right? That's all. This example, you have to focus one point here. I said collection framework, right? Collection framework allows one which data? Object data, I said. Wait, collections does not allow primitive data, right? Collections allows only which data? Object data. But tell me here, we are adding 10, right? Wait, here we are adding which value here? 10 or not? I said collections allows only object data, but here we are adding primitive, right? 10, 10.5, character, 10, these are primitive data or not? Then what is the point here? Here we are adding the primitive data, but the primitive data is automatically converted into object format. Okay. The primitive data is automatically converted to which format here? Object format. That concept is called which concept here? Auto boxing concept. So every collection class internal implementing auto boxing concept here. What do you mean auto boxing here? Automatic conversion of primitive to wrapper object. Primitive to which format? Wrapper object format is called auto boxing. We are adding int, right? That integer is converted into integer format. We are adding double, right? Double is converted into which format? Double format. We are adding char, right? The character is converted into which format? Character format. In this example, the first point is what? So every collection class internally implemented by using which concept here? Auto boxing concept. We are adding the primitives, but the primitives are automatically converted into which format? Object format. That is called auto boxing concept. Point number one, you have to focus. And point number two, toString method. al.toString. al.toString means al contains one data, different types of data. Different types of data, right? Different types of data or not? In every object, the toString method will be executed. We simply here array list. Array list contains one object or multiple objects. Multiple objects, right? And every object, every object which method executed? ToString executed. Okay. array list contains, okay, array list contains how many objects here? Multiple objects, right? Multiple objects, and every object which may be executed two string, right? That's all. But here we have only wrapper class data, string data, right? The string class, string buffer class, okay, string class, string buffer class, and all wrapper classes, the string integers, double, character, these all are wrapper classes, right? All wrapper classes. What is the two string returns? Two string returns data, right? That is the reason data only printing, right? That's all. The first point is you have to focus on auto boxing here. What do you mean auto boxing? Automatic conversion of primitive to wrapper object. That is called auto boxing. We are adding the primitives automatically convert into object format. Clarity important. These are the small points. We will get a lot of confusions when you go to the advanced. The clarity important. The second point is what? Two string method. Whenever you are printing the reference variable, it automatically calls the two string method. An array list contains one object, different objects, and every object two string will be executed. Every object two string executed, right? Here it contains only string data, wrapper classes data, right? String data, wrapper classes data, two string returns what? Content only, right? Return what? Return content of the object. That is reason content is printing or not. I think these two points are clear, right? That's all, guys. That's all the first example regarding your collection framework. That's all. Tell me, this is example one. Tell me, this is example number one. This is 1.5 version, right? 1.5 version, we have which concept here? Auto boxing. Which concept here? Auto boxing. So now, anyhow, I'm using which version? 1.8. Anyway, 1.8 means it supports auto boxing, right? It supports auto boxing means the code is like this. But what about up to 1.4 version here? Up to 1.4 version, there is no auto boxing, right? So up to 1.4 version, there is no auto boxing concept. If there is no auto boxing concept, then how to add the 10? To add the 10, we have to create the integer data. To create the wrapper object, integer dot value of method we have to use. So here what you have to use, double data, right? Double dot, the method name is called what? Value of, double dot value of. String means object, right? No issue. This is a character, right? Character dot, we have to use the value of method. Up to 1.4 version, we have to do the coding like this. Last one is integer, right? Then what you have to do? Integer dot, integer dot, the method name is called what? Value of method. That's it. Up to 1.4 version, there is no auto boxing concept here. So we have to write the coding like this. From 1.5 version onwards, okay, we can add the code like this, no issues. That is called auto boxing. Because of auto boxing, directly you can add the data. And one more point here, auto boxing is what? Automatic conversion, right? Automatic conversion means automatically this primitive is converted into which format? Object format, right? Automatic conversion means we are not doing here, we are safe side. But internally, that work is done by compiler actually. Okay, so this is the code, which one here? Before compilation, right? Let me show the code after compilation. Let me show the code after, after compilation, right? That's it. My point is clear, this one I said automatic conversion, right? Automatic conversion means we are not doing, but that work is internally done by compiler. Okay, so code after compilation. How to check the code after compilation here? Dot class file code, right? Let me check the dot class file code. Where is the workspace here? Local disk EF, collections applications. Here, what is the project name here? Array list example, right? In array list example, you will get the two folders here simply. What are the two folders? One is the bin folder and one is SRC folder. Wait, bin folder and what? SRC folder, right? The SRC folder contains .java files. Bin folder contains .class files. SRC folder and bin folder. SRC contains .java files. Bin contains .class files. Open the SRC folder. In the SRC folder, com.dss, test.java file, right? Test.java. Open the bin folder, the bin. See, what is the com.dss here? Yeah? This is a package. Package is nothing but folders, right? I given the package name is called com.dss. Then what happened here? Com folder and DSS folder is generated, right? conf folder, DSS folder. This is dot class file here. You can please open this dot class file. Open this dot class file by using Java decompiler software. Java decompiler software here. So in my system, I think I have decompiler software. So Java decompiler GUI. This is decompiler file. Just open the decompiler. So in online you have the multiple decompiler softwares here. Just you can check it once. This is a decompiler software. Just to open the file. So it is a file. This is PC. The location here, local disk F, collection applications, a released example, bin write, bin com dot dss dot test one file. Exactly. You clear? That's all, guys. This is the code after compilation, right? This is the code after compilation. Copy the same code here. You can place in your here. Package com.dss, print stream, array list is imported. Okay, so here you can check it. Integer dot value of, double dot value of, character dot value of, integer dot value of, right? It means this work internally doing done by compiler simply. We clear? That's all, guys. That's all about the first example regarding your collection framework. But tell me, in the project level, we don't have the 10, 20, 30, 40s, Ratana, Anu, Durga like that. We don't have the data like this. In the project level, always we have which data? Object data. I have thousands of employee objects. I have thousands of student objects. I have thousands of product objects, right? In the next video, we'll work with the object data here. This video, we are working with which data? Primitive data, right? Normal data. The next video, we'll work with what? Object data, right? That's all, guys. These points are clear, huh? Up to 1.4 version, we have to add the data like this. Integer dot value of, you have to create the wrapper object, right? Integer dot value of, integer dot, double dot value of, character dot value of. From 1.5 version onwards, directly we can add the data. Directly we can add the data. Okay, that is automatically converted to object format. That concept is called autoboxing. Automatic conversion means that conversion internally done by compiler. This is the compile. After compilation, the code is like this only. We clear? That's all, guys. Any questions? This example mainly how to focus on two points are auto boxing and two string method. ArrayList dot two string means the two string method will be executed on every object inside ArrayList. Now in this example, ArrayList contains integer data, string data, double data, character data. So in string class, string buffer class, all wrapper classes, two string returns what? Content of the object. We clear? That's all, guys. This is Eclipse ID, right? That's all. So thank you, guys. This is the first example regarding your ArrayList. So do the practicals only by using Eclipse ID. Because in the project level, in the real time, we have only Eclipse ID. We don't have any Notepad, Notepad++ kind of thing. Students, better, my kind suggestion is start the application, start doing the practicals by using Eclipse ID. No, Ratan sir, I will do Edit Plus only. No change, you can enjoy. Clear? That's all, guys. That's the video class number. How much done? Video class number 5, right? Good. The next video, the video class number 6, we'll discuss about the how to work with object data, like employee object, student object, how to work with the object data, right? That's all, guys. Thank you, guys. Thanks for watching. And like the video and comment the video. Subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you, guys. Bye.